Hello everyone and welcome back to episode 19 of the Ultimate Team. That's right, we've got just three more players we can possibly add to our squad before it is over and we have to play the big games against the big teams with what we have. Amazingly, we haven't lost a match yet and I do not plan on doing it now either, although we are playing one of the better sides from around the world. It is England we'll be taking on today and be looking to further strengthen our bench and get possibly our last backline player, because I think the last two guys both need to be forward. So we'll grab the old control Rooney. As always, we'll go across and have a look at this English team for today's match. Now, a lot of you have talked about Marco Vunipola as a possibility for a replacement in the props, whether it be a starter or a bench, a possibility on the loose head side, either which way. Let me know what your thoughts are on Marco joining the team. Of course, Dan Cole was another one I've thought about all along as being a possible player in the front row for our side. Do we want to go back to England? This will be our second time playing them, so we can come back to England one more time. Also, in the back row, the likes of a Rob Shaw, a Wood, or a Billy Vunipola. Nah, not too particularly too worried about them at this stage. I don't know if they're quite good enough to be on our reserves bench yet or not. But let me know your thoughts on those guys and the possibility of players in that English pack. Of course, the man we're going to be going for is none other than Ben Youngs, our replacement scrum half. He'll be starting on the bench. Of course, Aaron Smith is our starting scrum half. So Ben Youngs, great depth off the bench. He's 87 rated as well, which is just amazing rating for another scrum half to come off the bench from England. He's going to be who we're going after today. Then it's two episodes left. Who do we go for in those final two episodes? A prop, a back rower, a second rower. We need some more depth in those areas. We can grab two. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below for our last two matches. This team is almost complete. So let's get into our third to last player. It is Ben Youngs from England. We have to beat England and a lot at risk as well. So we just talked about it, a lot at risk for today's game. We have a few English players in our team already, none more notable than Owen Farrell. It'll be a huge loss if we cannot keep him in our team, and that would be only if we lost the game today to England. It's the Ultimate Team visiting Twickenham again, looking to take another player. Here is the English team. Of course, the man we're after is Ben Youngs, the scrum half. But it's a very, very good English side. Of course, undefeated in 2016. They've got a lot of good players. But most notably about the side again is that they do play quite well as a team. The players complement each other quite nicely in their roles. So Ben Youngs is a man we want. Of course, he'll go nicely if we have to shift around the back line. We have to move Farrell to a 10 or maybe Wally's at 12. Having Ben Youngs come off the bench for that little piece of injection could be quite valuable, but the rest of the squad, of course, dangerous. We want to win this game. Anthony Watson on the right wing, the midfield partnership. Daly and Joseph also dangerous as well without Farrell there. Very strong pack, so we've got to be careful here. England are a potential banana skin for the Ultimate Team. Well, I'll even say, as much as a banana skin's a bit of an insult to England, they're a good enough team to put anyone under pressure, and that could even be the Ultimate Team, despite the amazing talent that this side has. And probably for the first time, we're going to be going back-to-back, unchanged, starting 15 for the first time. I think it's the first time anyway. Of course, the player we got last episode was Dan Bigger. He's on the bench. We'll hopefully remember to bring him on later on in the piece if the result is going away. Even if it's not, the injection of a fresh player could be very much a good addition to the side. The Ultimate Team, though, very good team. Played very well last episode. The four-pack, especially the back row, was amazing. Pickamoles, Godza and Standout were fantastic. And the wingers as well, Habana and Odolo, were brilliant as well. So we want more of the same, please, from you boys. And we're going to do it against one of the best teams in the world. That is England. So we'll be kicking off today as the Ultimate Team, of course, in the amazing pink and white kit. And England, they're in the straight white, as per always, of the red rose on the chest. We are good to go. Owen Farrell on halfway. And kickoff is underway in our third to last episode of these stealing players part of this series anyway. It's a good take up there from Marco Vunipola, the man we're thinking about. Here's Billy going wide, straight out to Daly, who's wrapped up in a great tackle from Aaron Smith.
Advantage.
Holding up. Oh, that's advantage from forward pass. Dan Cole, what were you thinking? But I do feel sorry for him. That was a terrible call. There was no way that was forward. No way at all. And the ref has had an absolute nightmare there.
Set.
Scrum feed to the Ultimate Team. You almost feel if you could, you'd just give the ball to England and let them go with it. But that's not how we play. We play to win, and we have too much to lose to give this game away. Here is Pickamoles. Goes back to Aaron Smith, who centres the ball. Barrett, Coles, keeping it alive there. Nicely away to Robbie Henshaw. Henshaw's in behind. He looks wide. It's there for Nadolo. Inside ball to Ian Henderson. And Ian Henderson's in. Set piece try. But it all went very messy at the end. But somehow, they all hung on. Ian Henderson scores. The Irishman is in for his first try. That could be his first of the series as well. Robbie Henshaw. Great work there. The pass, just not quite on the money. Nadolo had to come infield to pick it up, but the support player of Ian Henderson running infield was just perfect. We see him trotting across in the background there. Bang! He had good gotcha there as well. Two very good support players. Second rowers that play like back rowers. Very, very valuable. Of course, Henderson can play in the back row as well. He's played there before. And he brings that diverseness to his game that is very valuable. Strong breeze here against the Englishman himself, Owen Farrell, playing against his countryman. And he adds the extras. There's no conflict of interest here for Owen Farrell. He wants to win, and he wants to get another Englishman in his team. George Ford, he's back to halfway. He's got all the kicking responsibilities now without Farrell on the team. Herrera, away it goes to Nadolo, trying to struggle off the tackle of Anthony Watson. The ball is very close to the sideline, but Stander has it now. He goes away to him, and it's a beef! And it's a beef goes through! The second row partner, Henderson! Could he go? Could he trundle? He'll do it all the way! His second try of the match! And two for the Ultimate Team as well. It's the Ian Henderson show. What on earth has he been doing this last few days? He has exploded out of the blocks. Ebenezer Beef breaks the line. And George Ford, the back in that chase, could not keep up. What a try. Vunipola was there. Wood was there as well. But they couldn't keep up. But I'm surprised that Ford just sat back. He didn't seem to be going full speed, and Henderson has made a mockery of them. He's in for a second try of the match. Ludicrous. Well, Ian Henderson, he's playing the game of his life at the moment. 14 minutes gone, and he scored two tries against England. Maybe it's the England-Ireland thing. He's fired up. And he's taken no prisoners. Owen Farrell adds the extras. He converts both his tries. And it's 14-0. England down already. And their heads cannot drop if they want to stay in this game. 15 minutes in. Ford back to halfway. I think he was very poor. Lazy running almost. He kicks off. This time goes very shallow. And it's a wobbly one out to Herrera. Finds Henderson. Uh-oh. Here's the Marnie Nadolo. Looking to link up. And he's put a poor pass away. England clean it up. He should have gone towards the touchline. Bowden Barrett has just picked that man up and deposited him somewhere. Oh, good turnover there, though. Watson picking the ball up from the clutches of Nadolo. Snow here. Where's the scrum half? Don't know where he is. But he's got it away now to Daly. He's picked up now. It's Aaron Smith. He throws out the back door. It's away to Nadolo. He'll go himself this time. He's taken out. But here comes Gonta. Oh, look out. There's pink jerseys everywhere. I think there was Bowden Barrett who comes screaming across and almost stole that ball. England do survive, however. And Gorgodza's on it again. Henshaw away to Habana. Oh, he's twinkle toes out of one. But pulled down, a great tackle from Wood. Great pressure as well, holds the ball back for England. Charging, and the line is forward, but he's pulled down. Good tackle coming in, rushing that defensive line. Again, they do it, but they've gone away to Cole this time. Two out from the race. Ultimate team up 14-0. Advantage. There's a lot of defense. Oh, that's another forward pass as Courtney Laws goes through a bit of a run. Could have been dangerous, but the ref pulls them back for a forward pass. Chris Robshaw. Oh, yeah, that one was forward. They put him in a lot of space, though.
Bind.
Stewie Hogg almost called into action. Scrum. Oh, England. I was about to say steady scrum from the Ultimate Team, but England have pummeled them backwards and will turn this ball over. What a play. Scrum turnover, England. Skipping out two players, going all the way out to Jason. Beautiful pop-up. Goes away to Daly. That was an exceptional pass to Elliot Daly there. Couldn't find support though. Here's Billy Woody Puller. There's no fullback there. Good God, says to pull Joseph down. Drags him down. Hartley slips it in field. Laws wanting another scamper. Oh, Standers turned it over. Nadolo's got the ball. Nadolo's running free. Comes up against Brown. Grabs it to the corner. Nadolo's winning this race by a canter. That is too easy. Nemani Nadolo turns the fence. It's a counter-attack short side try. There was not much happening for England down there. Almost happened. Slow motion. Stander over the ball. Pops it short. Nadolo said, okay, I'll have a go. Grubbers a pass. Brown is left for Dusty's. No chance. Watson's the only contender, but he was left as well. And a late comeback from Watson wasn't enough to stop Nadolo, who just, well, he just had a little deft grubber. Took his time, stayed composed, and got the ball down. Nemani grabs another. The Ultimate Team, they're under the pump there. England were putting the pressure on. And then they score. This English crowd, well, they were buzzing when England had the ball, but so quickly it turned around, and they've conceded. Strong breeze going into the face here of Owen Farrell as he lines up his third shot at goal. And it is easily done and dusted over. She goes, it's 21-0. The Ultimate Team thrashing England at the moment. Well, it's hard to believe anyone's going to give this team much of a test. George Ford kicks off again. High it goes. It's a beef to Coles. Bowden Barrett. Great pass to Gorgonza. Oh, he could have caught that and gone for a real run. Creating the space. Defenders drawing two men. And it leaves a massive overlap out wide. Could have been another try for the Ultimate Team, but they have been halted by a mistake. This English scrum, brutal in the first outing. Driving the Ultimate Team off the ball, and again, they've done it. Well, there may be a claim to having Marco Vunipola in the side. Why'd they come for Watson? He has done Nadolo in there quite easily. He frees it back to Marco Vunipola. Cole. Oh, that is a big clash. Gorgonza and Cole, two massive men. Clashing as Habana's got worked out wide, but oh, he smashed yard. He has absolutely dominated Marlon Yard on that right wing or left wing side for Yard in England. There was no chance of finding any room down there. The Ultimate Team doing this one quite comprehensively at the moment. 68% of possession, 75% of territory. Line break 7-3. England haven't even looked like scoring. Their rear chances have been quickly squashed and turned over and counterattacked on. So England need to protect the ball a bit better. And the Ultimate Team, well, if they just play like they did in the first, they'll be hard to stop in the second. Both sides making very similar tackle count, despite the position being very lopsided. It's 21-0. The Ultimate Team once again have one hand on Ben Youngs to take him to the glorious pink jersey. Well, look at that. It is a very somber looking George Ford to halfway. Downbeat England players. They look absolutely distraught. As up goes kickoff again. High. Henshaw goes back to Barrett. Not really what they had planned. Smith drops it off to Gorgonza. who takes a hit, and he's, well, that wasn't in the plan either. He's been completely isolated. They've lost the ball. Wood comes wide. They go out to Anthony Watson. He's the one who can make something happen. Back to Wood again, and show seven centre field.
Release.
This is good from England. They've come out of the blocks very strong. Slow, though, coming out of the back of that rock, and Release. Aaron Smith is rushing quickly up in defence. Wood to Cole. Passes off nicely. Joseph had a room there to make a gap. They've offloaded it brilliantly, and here's Billy Bunipula, who tries to stand well. Herrera's turned that over, and oh, Nadolo was through. Aaron Smith's picked it up. He's gone away to Cole. Someone needs to steady the ship here, and Coles does exactly that. England trying to hold on and turn this ball over. Farrell, horrible ball out to Stanley, gets it to Henshaw. He straightens the line up, fends through one, just about gets a pass away. A desperate tackle holds him down. Turnover ball though, England get it back. Now they look wide. Watson on Stander, but Stander is a strong defender. Little room to move there. Watson's pulled down. Oh, that's good from England. They're going to turn this over. It looked like they lost it, but they pull it back. Youngs, will he pull it? Away to Robshaw. This is great. Wood out wide. Habana's in trouble. Riad gets away. He gets a little bit of room. But Hogg and Henshaw shut the gate on him. A rare chance there for England to attack. Habana was caught in field as the line out goes to the back, and Aaron Smith goes back to Barrett. Brown is travelling across. Brown is in touch. Oh, he did not allow for the wind. And he's carried it over the sideline. Mike Brown with a mistake, and this is a chance of the Ultimate Team. They didn't need to do anything risky. They played it beautifully in the hands of the weather gods. And look at the reward they have. Nadolo. Oh, he's knocked that on. He created a massive overlap to his left. Was thinking too much about the pass, not enough about the run. Here he goes, charging into Joseph. That was debatably sideways as well.
Crouch, bind.
England's scrum Set. Has been by far the dominant of the two. And another big shove. England are on fire here with their scrum. Now they look to the right. Open side they go. Anthony Watson, he's been their chief play. Great ball inside. It's another chance for Robshaw. He's got to be wrapped up though. Yeah, you saw two or three pink jerseys jump up, and they wrapped Robshaw up without too much problem. 20 minutes to go. Strong wind here. Farrell was looking to kick to the left. He's changed his mind. He's allowed for the wind. He'll let it bounce and in touch it goes. No one had protected that sign for England. They should really think about the wind a bit more here. Now the Ultimate Team have a line out. Third in very quick succession. Coles to the back to Gurgonta. Smith running. Smith seeing a bit of a gap. Smith with a grubber. Smith goes again. Aaron Smith scores. Oh, what a brilliant try. No one expected the little scrum half to do it. He has put that through the gap like a needle through the middle of the haystack. He just ran off the back. Too much pace for Youngs. Hit the gap in the middle. Grubbed it past Mike Brown. And then Watson tried to clean it up, but there were so many pink jumpers there, they could not overcompensate. What a run from Aaron Smith. A little touch off the left, and then just drops down on it in the face of Mike Brown. What a great try. Owen Farrell now, he could add some more. This game is done and dusted. It is no contest. So this could make it 28-0. What a game this has been for the Ultimate Team. Have been far too good for England. Here's Owen Farrell launching another kick over. It's been one-sided as you like. 28-0. England unable to score against this side either. Oh, but here comes some changes for the first time. Noriega Pairs coming on for Tendai Tauwera. More changes. Hatakiyama coming on for Herrera as well. What else we got? Plenty more coming as well. Bigger on for Farrell. And we also see Bowden Barrett move to fullback. Hogg coming into the centres. And Kurandrani coming on for Henshaw. There's kickoff. Good God, sir, to Habana. Hogg. Oh, Hogg! What's he doing here? He's regathered that unbelievably. Kurunjani, he's going through the ball. Oh, what a try from the Ultimate Team. Stuart Hogg has sparked spectacular from a no opportunity play. That was ridiculous from Stuart Hogg. He just grabbed it through. They left him alone. Kurunjani just went for a little run. Mike Brown gets a palm in the face. And Kurunjani's too fast. And it was just Hogg. There was nothing on. He sparked just something brilliant. This is ridiculous. The depth of the benches has come to the fore amazingly. I can't even believe that that actually transpired. That's how ridiculous that was. And Dan Bigger's going to take over the kicking duties. Well, fair enough as well. Owen Farrell, of course, off the field. Bowden Barrett's a fullback, but Dan Bigger definitely a better kicker than Bowden Barrett. So over it goes. Bigger scores some points in the Ultimate Team. It's 35-0. But how about Stuart Hogg sparking from nothing? Here's George Ford, kicking high, very deep into the half of the Ultimate Team. Here's Habana, Kurunjani, it's a beat, quick hands, pick and moles. Hogg in the back line, good to see him there. Hatakiyama away to Nemanja Nadolo. If another one goes in, it will be really bad for England. The threat of losing Ben Youngs is completely gone now, as here comes the lead, pick and moles. Yard chases, and appropriately so, pulls them down. Pink jumpers coming to help. Gurgodza floats it away to Coles. Kurunjani, Henderson, quick hands away to Habana. One-on-one with Brown. Oh, again, Brown pulls him down. Good work. Quickly off they go. Kurunjani away to Louis Pickermoles. He started it all, and he finishes it in style. He is something else, isn't he? Louis Pickermoles. Put a team around him, and he continues to stand out. Well, the additions off the bench have been quite phenomenal. Too much speed for Hartley. Henderson and Coles are just the standouts for the Ultimate Team today. This has been one of their best performances, absolutely dismantling England. Pickermoles, just brilliant recently. You could not argue anyone else to wear that number 8 jumper. And here is Dan Bigger. He started it all at scrum half. And he'll finish it all now, because this game is all over. The final seconds. There goes the buzzer. The whistle will follow. Bigger adds the extras. It has been one team all day long, dominating. That is the Ultimate Team. They have hammered England as if to show a massive amount of dominance over world rugby. They've taken the best players. They've taken an amazing bench as well. And the impact that they've had late on for the last 20-25 minutes was just breathtaking. Having the adaptability of a fullback and a fly half that can swap, and the depth of the bench and the impact is just freakish. What a play, what a game from the Ultimate Team. 6 tries. Ian Henderson with a double. That's almost just silly to think about. Pickermoles with one. Aaron Smith, well, he got possibly nearly try of the series. Nadolo with another. Kurunjani capped it off with that freakish piece of skill from Stuart Hogg. Just grubbering it, popping it up short, and away goes Kurunjani. Farrell kicked 4 conversions. Dan Bigger kicked 2 in a completely comprehensive, dominant display. 42-0 the final score. Look at that. Possession 71%. Territory 63%. Tackles fairly even, but there was only one team in the scoreline. Line breaks 11-5. England didn't even score 1, but England's scrum did dominate. it did dominate comprehensively as well. Just like we did on the scoreline, they did in the scrum. So further thought for maybe a Dan Cole or Marco Vunipola. Your thoughts on that would be greatly appreciated. But 42-0, we have our man Ben Youngs in the team. He'll join the bench, which just looks even stronger now, and he'll be looking to come on and make an impact in our next match. Let's get him into the side. So we get our second English addition to the team, our third English player overall, so we can still play England one more time if you guys think that we need to. We'll look at the teams and players we want in a second. Let's get Ben Youngs in there. We'll put Fotolii down into the reserves. That means we've got Youngs, we've got Bigger, we've got Kurandrani, we've got Kolishvili, Diego Moore, Hatakiyama, and Noriega Paz. Okay, two episodes left, so it's two players we can pick up. What I want is a prop. I want a prop. So we need a prop. Can I make it any more clear? Dan Cole, Marco Vunipola, Giffen Jenkins. Who else? We can't play New Zealand. We can't play Ireland. We can play Wales. We can play England once more. We've still got a few options. The other player that I think we need is a second row / back row. Now, possibly to replace Kolishvili. I think he's been great in this series, no question about that. But it's not a world-class player for an ultimate team like this. So really, ideally, we want to replace Hatakiyama on the bench, whether that means replacing Ntoawera or Herrera in the starting lineup. One of them can drop back to the bench, and Hatakiyama can go to the reserves. And we want to put Kolishvili on the reserves as well. So we need a back row / second row. Either of them can replace either or. I know we've got Ian Henderson who can play in the background, the second row as well. So we've got plenty of diverse positions. So get your thinking caps on. Two matches to go. We want a back rower and a front rower. Noriega Paz is good enough to stay there as well. We could go for two front rowers and leave Kolishvili, but that is what my thoughts are for the last two episodes. Let me know what you think as well. Could go for an Elwyn Jones as well as another option for that position as well. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Other than that, the team, I think, is pretty much made. We've pretty much made our starting 15. Now we just need to top it up, fix up the front row. Ntoawera, I quite like Herrera. He's amazing. Ntoawera, a lot of you don't like Ntoawera there, but he's good enough to be in the team. So we'll leave him in the team. Whether he'll start or not, don't know. His versatility off the bench could be invaluable to our side as well. But that wraps up today's episode. It's been a classy one at that too. Great tries from the Ultimate Team. We've picked up Ben Youngs. We have a last little look at him before we say goodbye. And we have a bench which is almost looking perfect. Stephen Moore will stay as our reserve hooker. I think he's good enough to be there as well. He deserves that spot in the team. But that is it. Today's episode complete. We have two to go before our team is complete. Then we have the challenges against the Lions and the likes, and then it is the big ones against the Cannon. Hope to see you all there for the next one as well. Thank you for tuning in and watching. Thank you all for your comments as well, and I'll see you all next time. Until then, take care.